For instance, shark conservationists in Australia have called for a rebrand for shark attacks, suggesting we should refer to them as negative encounters or interactions. Well, we can't accuse them of inaccuracy there. Having your leg chewed off by ravenous fish certainly does fall into the negative encounter category. And maybe the phrase shark attacks is having a detrimental impact on the shark's self-esteem. I'm not an animal psychologist, I just don't know. And the Entomological Society of America has said they want to rename the gypsy moth and the lesser-known gypsy ant because these terms are offensive. This follows what the society calls an inclusivity drive to, quote, ensure that insect names are respectful. I'm not sure exactly how many racist attacks have been incited through the medium of moths, but better safe than sorry. Sticking with the animal theme, experts at the UK's biggest cat blogging website, Cats and World, have told pet owners that they should seek their cat's consent before stroking them or picking them up. True, some cats do struggle with English, but as the website says, you can always look out for subtle body language, a twitching of the whiskers, perhaps, or a fluttering of the tail. There can be no excuses for non-consensual feline intimacy. Meow means meow. From animals to publishing, the American Booksellers Association has issued an apology for including Abigail Schreier's book, Irreversible Damage, in a selection of book samples sent to independent publishers. They claim that the book is anti-trans, which shows that they haven't read it, and they further claim that its inclusion in their sample list was a serious violent incident. I'll say that again. It was a serious violent incident. It's a little disturbing, really, isn't it? A body that specialises in the written word doesn't know the definition of violence. The airline Lufthansa has said it is dropping gender-related terminology from its onboard announcements. So you won't hear any more of those outrageous safety instructions directed to ladies and gentlemen or boys and girls, because that, quite obviously, would be a serious violent incident. And those planes are quite large, so we're talking a lot of passengers here who could be injured through hearing those offensive words. Quite frankly, I would rather the plane went down in flames than anyone on board was misgendered. But don't worry, I'm sure we will achieve our utopian goal of full gender inclusivity thanks to the new emojis that are being rolled out on social media. These now include a range of pregnant men, such as the one you're seeing there. This is long overdue, of course, because I constantly find myself trying to talk about my pregnant male friends over Twitter through pictorial form, and now I can finally do it. This is what progress looks like.
Welcome to the GB News YouTube channel. You can watch us live 24 hours a day, catch up on your favourite shows, and join in the conversation in the comments below.
Don't forget to subscribe and you'll never miss any of our exclusive content.